Very good morning once again. And today we are going to learn about another welding process, which is called flux cored arc welding, or it is popularly known as FCAW. Let me take you to the lecture. In the case of flux cored arc welding, so it uses a continuous wire electrodes, and also these electrodes are flux cored. So you can, if you look at the image pasted below, you can see the flux cored electrode, which means the core or the inner part will be a flux covered by the electrode material. Okay, that's why it's called a flux cored electrode. And also the cross section of the flux cored electrode is shown here in the inside. You can see it, how it looks like, the cross section of the flux cored tubular electrode wire is shown here. And what will happen? So actually the flux will get melted during the welding process, and it will form a slag coating over the molten weld metal. You can see it here. This is a molten metal. This is a molten metal, and you can see this is a drop of slag which is going to get deposited and covered over the molten weld metal. So the flux will get melted during the welding process and will form a slag coating over the molten weld metal. There are two variants of flux cored arc welding. They are so we can classify it like this: one with the gas shield and without gas shield. Usually when we use gas shield, the purpose of gas shield is to cover the area of welding from contamination, that you know, isn't it? The contamination by atmospheric air, to cover the area of the welding from this contamination, we use a gas shielding. So usually a carbon dioxide based shielding gas is used if a gas shield is used. And when the gas shielding is not used, the flux itself will contribute sufficient gas shielding in the area of welding. And if you look at some of the advantages, disadvantages and limitations, applications of FCAW, advantages includes high deposition rate can be achieved with the small diameter wires, and also high quality weld metal deposit and excellent appearance is obtained with this welding process. And also limitations include large amount of fumes generated by flux cored wires, and also this welding process usage is limited to ferrous metals and nickel based alloys. And if we look at some of the applications for fabricating structures using carbon and low alloy steels, this welding process is widely used. It also used in the construction of pressure vessels and piping for chemical processing. Thank you.